So in today's lecture of EE452, HVDC in fact, we will discuss about the introduction of HVDC transmission. What is HVDC? HVDC stands for high voltage direct current. What is the necessity of HVDC? So we will discuss here in this slide that nowadays, a large block of power are needed to be transmitted. There arises some technical problems of transmitting power to such a long distance using AC, alternating current. In the view of the drawbacks of AC, the HVDC transmission has come into picture. Before discussing the large blocks of power, we will discuss about the types of transmission system available in India. So there are two types of transmission systems available. One is EHV-AC and the other one is HVDC. In EHV-AC, the voltage length of transmitting extra high voltage starts from, if we go from the higher side, it will be from 767 kilovolt, 400 kV, 220 kV, 132 kV, 66 kV, which is nowadays very rarely used, 33 kV, 11 kV. These are the transmitting voltages. Transmission line voltages in AC system. Below that there is a distribution system which is from 440 volt to 220 volt. This is three phase, this is single phase. So we are discussing about the EHV AC or AC transmission system. So this is not required. Now, as in the first line it shows that nowadays large block of power are needed to be transmitted. So how a transmission line works? First we will see how a transmission line works. Let's say this is a generating station, a bus bar, transmission and distribution. So this is generator, this is load, bus bar, or we can say substation. Sending end, service station, receiving end, and this is the transmission line. In case of EHV AC, as the voltage range we written that 11 kV, 33 kV, 132 kV, 220 kV, 400 kV, 766 kV. So why voltage range are taken such a higher value? So that the losses of transmission will be reduced. as we increases the voltage range, as we increases transmission line voltages, the transmission line losses reduces. As we increase the transmission line voltage, the transmission line losses reduces, because as the voltage increases, the current goes down and the major I square R losses will reduce. I square R losses will reduce. So that's why we will take higher voltages for transmitting the power. Now, what are the major constraint in case of EHVAC? The major constraint is the infrastructure. In case of three-phase transmission or EHVAC transmission, three-phase line has to be erected so that the path that cover the transmission tower covered a large area, and also the right of path is being created for transmission, for erecting the EHVAC transmission. So there arises some technical problems of transmitting power to such a long distance using AC. So what are the technical problems? The technical problems are reactive power. We have to maintain the reactive power throughout the transmission line, and also corona losses will increase. In case of long distance transmission lines, there are capacitance has been formed, so and it will charge. So these are the technical problems, and many more technical problems which will be discussed in a later slide. Now, in view of the drawbacks of AC, EHVAC transmission line, the HVDC transmission has come into picture. The first DC link was set up in 1954 in between Swedish mainland and Iceland of Gotland. The use of HVDC link in an AC system requires converter station at each end of the line. Now, what are the advantages of DC transmission or HVDC transmission? There are two major classification of advantages. One is technical advantages and also economic advantages. In technical advantages, the reactive power requirement. Second, system stability, short circuit current, independent control of AC system, fast change of energy flow, lesser corona loss and radioactive interference, greater reliability. So these are the technical advantages. So we'll see one by one. First is the reactive power requirement. In case of EHVDC transmission, there will be no reactive power requirement, as the power is flowing in DC nature. So at sending end, we don't have to send reactive power as in case of EHVAC transmission. So the power which is flowing in HVDC transmission line is the real power. Second, system stability. In case of EHVDC, the system is more stable as compared to the EHVAC transmission line. In DC transmission, the system stability is more, system is more stable as compared to EHVAC. The short circuit current, the independent control of AC system. So in case of independent control of AC system, if the two different AC system or two different AC system of different frequencies. Say this is a system 1, this is system 2. These are AC system. And if these two AC system are having different frequencies, say suppose this is having 50 Hz and this is having 60 Hz. So now if these frequencies, these systems are connected through HVDC link or DC link, so it can be connected and both the system will work independently, which is not possible in case of EHVAC or AC system. Next is fast change of energy flow. As in case of EHVDC, there is this is the generator, this is the load, generator, load, and these are the converter station 1, this is converter station 2. Here the AC is converted into AC is converted into DC, and here once again the DC is converted into AC. So the fast change of energy flow, the energy can be flown from here to here or here to here. So if we want to change the flow of energy or flow of power from one end to another end, so at this particular case, in case of DC system, as there is only resistance in the transmission line, the change of flow is very fast. Now laser corona and radio interference, as there will be less corona losses as compared to AC line, and radio interference is also very less because the interference mainly occurs due to capacitance and inductance, which is absent in case of HVDC. Greater reliability, as the system is stable, the system is more stable, so it will be the reliability of the system is higher. No limit in transmitting distance. As in case of EHVAC, there are some constraints. As the distance, the power is to be transmitted. But in case of HVDC, the constraint of distance is being eliminated. The direction of flow can be changed very quickly, as we have discussed in just now. Now what the previous are the technical advantages, now the economic advantages. Number one, DC lines and cables are cheaper than AC lines and cables. The tower of DC lines are narrower, simple and cheaper compared to tower of AC line. The line losses in DC are lower than the line losses in AC line. So we'll discuss one by one. The DC lines and cables are cheaper. Why they are cheaper? Because the same amount of power can be transmitted at using a single conductor, which we will discuss later in this session. So the cost of the conductor is being reduced. Same as in case of tower, the DC lines are narrower as compared to AC lines because less number of tower and the and also the tower height is being is smaller as compared to HVAC transmission. Transmission line losses in DC lines are lower because here only the I2R loss is present as compared to in case of HVAC line there are losses due to resistance, inductance and capacitance. Now this is the pictorial view of AC system or HVDC system. Here the comparison, the AC system, it is written the representing length AC system versus DC system. So in case of AC system, the cable length is from 50 to 80 km, whereas in case of DC system there is no limitation. Now as we compare the prices of AC and DC transmission, so in this particular graph here it shows the distance in kilometer and here the price, you can say the red line is from the AC and blue line is from the DC price. So as you have seen, as the distance increases, the cost of erection of DC line is lesser as compared to the cost of AC line. Why it is so? Because of in case of DC, the initial cost is higher as compared to the HVAC system. Initial cost is higher because of the converter station. In case of HVDC, in case of HVDC, the AC is being first being converted into DC with the help of converters, and at receiving end, once again the DC is being converted into AC with the help of inverter. So the cost of converter station at sending end and cost of inverter station at receiving end will increase the initial cost. But as the transmission line distance increases, and as you see here, this is the break-even point, around 700 km, in between 700 km, the AC is now, DC is now cheaper as compared to AC, and beyond this distance, the price of DC transmission is less as compared to AC transmission. Now types of DC links, there are three types of DC links: monopolar, bipolar, homopolar, and one more DC link are also used, that is back-to-back DC link, which is used to connect two different systems. So in case of monopolar HVDC link, as seen shown in figure, this is the terminal transmission line and terminal B. We'll draw one more figure here. This is generator.
basically monopolar monopolar HVDC ring. As the name suggests, only one polarity is being transmitted, or power is being transmitted through a single polarity, positive or negative. So here the electrical energy is being generated. It is in the form of AC. The converter station will convert this AC into DC. And it is transferred, the power is being transferred through the transmission line with a single polarity. So this is known as monopolar. At the receiving end, once again, a converter station 2, which is also known as inverter, is converted this DC into AC signal, and it is given to for the distribution purpose. So this is the monopolar link. In case of monopolar, the transmission power is using a single conductor, and the return path is being taken from the earth. So this is the simplest type of HVDC link. Also, the cost is less as compared to other HVDC link, and also the less power is being transferred on single conductor. Next is bipolar link. So in this particular case, both the polarity, positive and negative, if the power is transferred through both the polarity. So once again, if we draw the figure here, this is positive polarity and this is negative polarity. So this is generator and say load. In this particular case, the power has been transferred to positive as well as negative polarity. So the two conductors are here used, whereas in case of monopolar ring, only single conductor is being used. So the transmission cost is increased slightly, but the power which transferred through bipolar ring is now doubled as compared to the monopolar ring. So this is the advantages of bipolar ring. Also, one more advantage is here. Suppose a link is being failed. So at that particular instant, in case of monopolar, the power is being interrupted. The transmission of power is being interrupted. But in case of bipolar link, the power is being is transferred through the other polarity. Yes, the amount of power is being reduced, but the continuity is still maintained, and hence the reliability will be higher in case of bipolar link as compared to monopolar link. Next one is homopolar. In case of homopolar ring, as shown in this figure, both the conductors are having the same polarity in case of monopolar ring. So in case of monopolar, only a single conductor is being used for transmitting the DC power with the help of either positive or negative polarity. In case of monopolar in case of bipolar ring, both the polarity is being used, positive and negative. And in case of homopolar ring, the same polarity is being used for transmitting the power in both the conductors. Now, incorporating HVDC into AC system, so two terminal DC link point to point transmission. Back to back DC link in parallel with AC link and multi terminal DC link. These are the types where both AC and DC HVDC system is incorporated in AC system to increase the reliability and stability of EHV-AC. So this is also one application of HVDC. Here, in case of back-to-back DC link, in case of back-to-back DC link, suppose this is station 1, station 2, so now this station 1 is connected to station 2 with the help of back-to-back DC link. Now power is being either transferred from here to here, here to here, without transferring the abnormality of one station to another station or one system to another system. So this is the advantage of back-to-back system. As I have already discussed that if this system is having 50 Hz frequency and this system is having 60 Hz frequency, then also we can transfer power from one station to another or from second station to first station. Now there are the equipment which is used in converter station: thyristor valves, converter transformer, DC reactor, harmonic filtering equipment, control equipment, reactive power compensation. These we will have discussed in detail. Ground return. So most DC transmission line uses ground return for the reason of economy and reliability. As in case of monopolar ring, the returning path is taken through ground. So ground return, so economically how it is benefited economically? So a single conductor is being used, so the cost of conductor is saved, also the tower cost is reduced. Ground return are used by the monopolar and bipolar link for carrying the return current. We'll discuss this. The ground path has low resistance and therefore low power losses as compared to a metallic conductor path provided the ground electrode are properly designed. The resistance of ground path is independent of the depth of the lines. These are the few points related to the ground return. Now, what are the problems associated with the ground return? So, first problem is design of grounding electrode for low cost of installation and maintenance, and location and screening of electrode so that ground current cause negligible electrolytic collision of buried and immersed metallic structures. These are the two technical problems which are associated with the ground return. So whenever we design a EHV-AC transmission line or an EHV-DC transmission line, so we have to take care of these two points. Next is earth electrode. So HVDC system requires a properly designed earth electrode at each station. The earth electrode is situated at a safe distance from 5 km to 50 km from the station. The station is converter station. And the earth electrode at one of the station act as anode and at other and act as cathode. So these are the points about earth electrodes. Now, previously the converter stations are used thyristor valves, but nowadays GTOs, gate turn off switch, have come into use. Also, use of is active AC and DC filter, and advanced fully digital control systems using optical fiber are used for the HVDC transmission line for controlling the power from one end to another end. Now, to conclude this talk, the recent studies indicate that HVDC systems are very reliable. The data collected from 31 utilities says that forced unavailability of energy due to converter station is very less, that is 1.62%, and scheduled unavailability of energy is about 5.39%. So, by using the HVDC link, the reliability is increased. Also, the availability of power is increased. Thank you.